Starting with the statistics, why statistics in psychology, right? So statistics is, I mean, earlier, even during the statistic, even during our chat, this particular question came up, right? So it is one of the very, very important subjects as far as research is concerned. Let's say if you are studying people and trying to deduce certain attributes, or you're deducing certain conclusions, dealing with data is something which is inevitable. So you are going to collect samples, you are going to collect various parameters which are required, and finally you will deduce out of that data. So entire subject is all about deducing from that particular data. So there are various ways, various concepts which are required to be known. And that is exactly why statistics is the subject here. So it's a very important subject, especially the one who is going to do research. They can't get away with statistics. So it's going to be a very important from that manner, right? So few terminologies which roll out everywhere, right? I mean, to start with, there is, so here we are talking about data. So there is a terminology called as population. So what exactly population means? So population is like, let's say you are trying to measure what is the average height of entire Karnataka state, let's say, as an example, right? So Karnataka state is an entire population that you are actually dealing with. So it is the complete set of all the data elements where you are trying to actually, study. So the entire Karnataka state population, each and every individual is the full population of that particular question. And what exactly is sample? So when we are actually studying this, what is the average height of Karnataka, people in Karnataka? It's not going to happen that you are going to go to each and every individual house, measure each and every individual, and and then collect the statistics and average out. You can't do that because it's too huge to collect. So what you will do, see, you will randomly pick people, take a sample, and then you will actually, apply whatever the techniques that you want to apply to calculate the height. And then you will reach to the conclusion saying that this is what is the average height of Karnataka. So what we are doing is, in the entire population, we are taking the sample and studying that particular sample. So that is the critical difference between the word population and sample. Right. So, and there are other few, very known terms, for example, average or mean. I think most of us know what average is. So I don't probably, explain a lot. Basically, what you are doing, you are collecting data, adding all the values. Let's say if you got the height of 10 individuals, you are taking all the 10 values, saying that one is 6 foot, the other is 5 foot, the other is 4 foot, etc. You are taking all the 10 values, summing up, adding all of them, and dividing by number of samples that you collected. So it's like you are just adding all of them and dividing with the number of total number of samples. 10 samples are there, you are dividing by 10. So that is average. So I think most of us really know it. In that way, there are other two things as well apart from average. The one is median. So I'll show an example so that you can, I'll share my screen and show an example so that I just collected a few examples so that I don't have to write those examples here. So all these things, so when we are talking about mean, median, mode, standard deviation, variables, there are various things that I'm going to explain. All these are various calculations that can give important conclusions about the data. So we talked about statistics as concluding from the data, right? So these are some of the formulas where these are going to tell something about the data. So when you say what is the average height, it tells it tells a property of that particular population. So basically it is telling something. Similarly, All these other things which I'm going to explain are all various things which are going to tell in different ways. The other one is median. So median, unlike average, so in case of average, what you are doing, you are taking all of them, adding them, and then dividing by the population. But this is not going to give the picture of, let's say, you know, somebody can be 7 foot and somebody can be 5 foot. So it is not really, you know, giving the picture in an entirety. That is where you will really require various other ways of studying the data. In case of median, what median does is, let's say if you have you know, a sample, let's say sample here is 3, 9, 15, 17, 14. So these are the data that you collected. So similar to height, let's say this is one of the attribute that you collected, and this is the final you know, data that you got. If you arrange it in an ascending order, so starting from the small, if you just arrange all the values, whatever that you received, in an ascending order, if you see here, it is actually in an ascending order, starting with 3, 9, 15, 17, 14. So place all of them in an ascending order. Take what exactly is the value which is standing in the middle. That is median. So here you are not really, you know, combining all of them. You are just saying who is exactly in the middle of the population. So he is wherever, you know, wherever this is, he is neither too short nor too long. He is just exactly in the middle. So it is telling the positioning. So this is this particular value is really telling about the positioning of the data. The other one is mode. So here, this particular calculation is telling what is the frequency. So so let's say I have you know, various samples here again as an example, right? I mean, I have 3, 3, 8, 9, 15, 15, 17, 17, 27, 40, 44. So these are, assume that these are heights in centimeters or whatever it is. So again, if you see average, it is all calculating and dividing. In case of median, you are going to reach to a conclusion that this, in the middle one is the median one. But in case of mode, what it is telling is, it is going to tell the frequency. If you see here, 3 is occurring twice, 8 is occurring once, 1, 9 is occurring 1, 15 is occurring 3 times, 17 is occurring 2. So the highest number that is most frequently, you know, whatever that is occurring, that is exactly the mode. So this is going to tell that, so most often, this is going to be the height of an individual. So this is like a frequency. This is the most popular height, rather, right? If you take height itself as an example. So in this particular case, unlike mean, where mean is going to actually, it is going to be a single number, right? Because you are going to add all of them and then divide. It is going to be a single number that you are going to arrive. So whether it is 100 values that you have or you know, 50 values that you have, you are going to sum it up and you are going to conclude with one number in case of mean. Similarly with median as well, median, let's say if you have odd number of samples, it is very, very clear that the middle one is going to be the median. So it is very clear in this particular case, it is 15. Let's say if you have a you know, even number of samples, then both 8 and 12 are in the median, right? So there one way is to actually, you know, take the average of these two and then conclude that yes, you know, it is going to be 10, which is going to be the median of this particular thing. That is one way to actually tell. But actually in the middle, both 8 and 12 are the median for this particular sample. But in case of mode, this particular frequency, right? I mean, we are talking about the frequency. So in this particular example, whatever that we have, it is very clear that 15 is the mode because that is the most frequent. But imagine there is one less 15, right? So what is going to happen? We have 15 twice, 17 twice, 44 twice, 3 twice. That means we have 4 different modes. So mode can be any number, I mean, any number of modes. It need not to be a single mode. So it can be more than one mode. So it depends on the frequency, right? So that's about most popular terminologies where we are talking about population, sample, median, mean, and mode, right? Next comes standard deviation, right? I mean, even before standard deviation, what I will I'll talk about a few other concepts. So here when we are actually arranging the data, right? So these are all deduced values. Let's say now you really require to actually deduce more complicated stuff, right? So there is a concept called as distribution. So what exactly distribution means is, let's say you have collected all the samples, you have collected all the data. So now you would want to really place it in a graph and see how exactly that data really behaves. So when you actually put it in a graph, you can actually deduce a lot of things. I'll talk about what are the things that could be deduced in terms of these particular stuff. Let me explain the distributions first, and then go to those particular things what can be deducible out of it, right? So if you take a sample, and if you are actually putting each and every, when it comes to mode, right? We talked about frequency. So here 3 occurs twice, 8 occurs once, 9 occurs once, 15 occurs thrice. So if you actually place each and every number, put up a frequency under which it really appears, right? I mean, so if you put a table like 3 occurs twice, and 8 occurs one, 9 occurs one. So it is like if you are putting in a tabular format like this, and consider one as X value and the other as Y value. I hope people really understand how really graph works, right? I mean, when you are putting a two-dimensional graph, you have X, which is the axis, which is down. If you actually see this, right? I mean, whatever. Yeah, somebody was telling something. Hello?
No, Praveen, please carry on.
Please go ahead.
Okay.
Kavin, okay. Can you go into presentation mode if you don't mind? Aging, sure. Eyesight. Thank you.
No problem. So if you see this particular graph, right, as an example one, so there is one axis which is going down and the other which is going up. So you can actually consider this as an x-axis and this is as a y-axis. So you can actually put x value which is here, so when you take a coordinate, the one which I explained, right? I mean, putting frequency on one side and the variable on the other side. So if you take one as x value and one as y value and plot, put the points. So let's say you are putting a point where 3, right? 3 is twice. So you can put at the 2 and 3 from here, put a point here. So similarly, if you just accumulate all the points, right, so there is a graph that it forms. So when we are talking about distribution, what we are talking about is these particular graphs. So basically you are putting all the data in a graphical way and then trying to study that particular stuff. So now in these particular distributions, there are various types. So what is X, what is Y? Based on that, there are actually various types of distributions that really come into picture. So one of the most popular name that you would really find in entire unit is normal distribution. But other than that as well, there are quite a few distributions. And what distribution really requires, it depends upon the nature of data. So for example, So there are various types of data that are there. Right? I mean, depending upon the type of data, we'll talk about those particular types. But depending upon the type of data, you will determine what exactly are the distributions that you are going to use to study the data. So if it is, if you're studying a binary valued stuff, let's say you are talking about just a true or false kind of a thing, then you are going to use binomial distribution. So similarly, if it is a continuous variables where the variable can form, variable can be anywhere, probably these particular concepts might be, we'll explain it more later, but the point that you really require to understand is depending upon your nature of data, the types of distributions really change. So it's not that everything really fits into a normal distribution, which is more popular in our subject. So there are various types of distributions which are there. And these distributions are typically, you know, calculated like X and Y and plot the data and put it. So in certain cases, this X and Y is nothing but X value could be your sample, that is 3, whatever that we deduced in this particular case, this 3. And Y value could be the frequency. So in case if you are deducing the frequency and plotting that particular distribution, then it is called as a frequency distribution. So similarly, there is another type which is called as a probability distribution. So what probability distribution is you are having a formula way of deducing Y. Let's say you have a calculate. So instead of frequency, you are putting Y, X and calculating based on a certain a formula, then that actually goes as a probability distribution. So basically what you are saying is, just as an example, right? You are saying Y is equal to some 0.3x plus 5 or something like that. So it is like a functional value. So Y, you are not simply calculating Y as frequency of X. So you have a formula to derive Y. So in case 3 is the value here, your probability based on this particular function would be 3 into 3 plus 5, that is going to be 14. So here Y value is 14. So you are actually deducing based on a certain formula, not like frequency. So that is probability distribution. Okay, those are the different distributions which are there, right? I'll not go into details of all distributions, but these are very common ones. So now what is a normal distribution? The most used one here. Let's say if you have a data, which is quite a large, population where you are actually studying something which can occur at any point. So there is no fixed interval. So if you take the same example of height, right? Height can be, it doesn't have any fixed interval. So basically what it means is height can be 6.1.5 or 5.1.2.5. So it can be continuous. So there is nothing like, you don't have an interval or a range as far as the height is concerned. It can fall at any point of time. So typically when you have such continuous data, so basically continuous variables, that's where normal distribution is used. So if you see that, right, I mean, normal distribution, how exactly normal distribution is, to give a very simplistic way, what exactly normal distribution is telling is, let's say if you have a population and you are plotting that population here. So the fag end, the end of it, if you see this tail, you have very less number of people who are going to be of height, which is taking the same example of height, right? What this particular thing is telling is you have very less number of people who have a height which is less than 1 foot, let's say, right? And you, similarly, as you go, right, you have more number of people who are probably, 5'3 or 5'4 or whatever it is. And then the extreme end, again, above 7 or whatever, you have very less number of people again. So here, imagine this height is telling us how many people are in this particular height range. So imagine that there is a height which is running under now, and here the height is telling the number of people who are falling under that particular bracket of height. So imagine in that way. So it is telling that any data which you, if you take, it really goes and fits into this particular normal distribution. And that means this fag end is very, very less, and this extreme fag end is also very, very, you know, less. And you have a middle, which is like a hump, which is actually, you know, coming as this particular curve. So normal distribution really appears like this. So now coming to the point where we left on standard deviation, right? So what standard deviation is going to tell? So take this particular example itself, where you have a curve like this. And what you are really saying is the one which is in the middle is the one which is most prevalent one, right? I mean, this is the one which most number of people are really having this particular height is what you are telling exactly in the middle axis. So now if you want to actually, you know, but if you have to study more here, not everybody is of that particular height. Imagine that this middle is 5'4". You are saying most of the people are of height 5'4". But that doesn't really, you know, tell a lot. So you want more information to really describe. So if somebody asks, like, I mean, what is the 65% of where exactly, you know, 65% of the population really fall, right? So what exactly is the confidence that you have that everybody is going to fall under this particular thing? So such, in order to answer such questions, so the concepts like standard deviation, other things really, you know, came into picture. So standard deviation is nothing but if you plot this particular graph and then take each and every point, and you are trying to calculate how much those particular points are deviated from the middle. So what you are literally saying is we have individuals of 5'4", and so individuals who are in 5'1 is deviated by this much. There is a quantity that you are saying. Individuals who are deviating from, you know, what you are saying is certain individuals who are less than 5'4", there are certain individuals who are more than 5'4". So you are calculating distance from the middle and how far they are deviated. And then you are actually, you know, telling that, so a standard, one standard deviation, which you are saying is, 68.2% of the population really, you know, falls under. So one standard deviation means 68% of the population really falls under that particular bracket. You are giving a range and you are telling that 68% are falling under this particular bracket. And standard deviation really tells what exactly is the width of this particular deviation. So what it also, one more thing which I wanted to tell when I'm talking about width. Here, when we are talking about normal deviation, normal distribution, it talks about the curve being like this, right? I mean, basically one end low, the other end also low, and there is a hump. But this hump could vary in height. So the tower could be lengthy in certain cases, and tower could be low in certain cases. That means you have more flattish curve, right? I mean, a curve which is like going, you know, more flat. So there, standard deviation is more. In order to tell that 68% of the population has got a lot more variety. So what you are literally saying is, even though 5'4 is of is the most frequent height, but actually population is equally distributed because hump is very, very, you know, flat. So in order to tell with confidence, you have a lot of standard deviation. You have more deviation in the data. So data is much more distributed. But let's say if hump is very, very, you know, less, let's say if the hump is like this, very less, what you have is the deviation is less. You have more confidence. You are saying that, yes, most number of people are in 5-4 because the deviation is not much. The distance between those particular heights is not much. So all are around that 5-4, even though there are other populations at the other heights, but they are all around 5-4. The hump is very, very steep in height. And when the hump is flat, you are saying even though 5-4 is the middle, it is equally deviated. So there is a lot of deviation in the data is what we are saying. And that's how deviation is helping us to really find out various properties of the data here.
So, Praveen, can I ask a question here? I have a doubt.
Yeah, please. Yeah.
So when you say standard deviation, you're saying it's a deviation from the median or the middle.
So that
means it's a range. In the sense that, let's say you're saying the height and the mean is 5.4, standard deviation is a range from 5.1 to 5.4?
No, not like that. So basically, it is the distance. So it is not the range. What you are saying here is, what you are telling is this particular data, which is plotted here, let's say, from the middle, you have plotted somewhere in the middle. If this particular, whatever the data that is there is of this distance from the, from the middle. So let's say I have 5-4 as the middle value, and there is an individual who is of 6 height. So the distance between 6 and 5-4 is almost like, you're talking about 8 inches. So that is the distance, right? So similarly, if you have another individual who is of 5-5, the distance between these two is only 1. So now you calculate all of the individuals other than the middle one. Middle one is exactly falling on 5-4. And you are talking about, let's say you are calculating distance of all of the other individuals, how far they are deviated. And then telling one single value, saying that these many individuals are deviated by this distance. So you're not really giving the range. You are just telling that how flat the curve is, how tall the curve is. So it is only telling that, everybody is, let me just try to draw using pen.
You're saying the number, so you're saying that it tells you how many individuals have deviated from the mean, the median, basically from the center.
How lengthy this particular curve is. Let's say if it is like this. So the distance here between this and this hump is, let's say, 4, let's say, just to give a number, right? Mm-hmm. And if the curve is, something like this, right? So here the distance is, let's say, right? Okay, so here what you are saying, you have more individuals who are away from the median. So there is a middle line for sure, but there are more people who are away from the middle one. So here what you are saying is all of them are just lying around here only, so they are not really very far. Here you have a lot of people. What this distance is telling us is just that the people are more varied. You have more, variety of people. The middle value is not really, giving, there are a lot many people who are deviating. So still it is a distance you are talking about. It is not a range. So if you take this particular curve, so it is not really, range here. But it is the distance that you are actually talking about.
So in other ways, to simplify this for my understanding, standard deviation gives you an idea of how spread out or diverse your sample size is in the median.
Correct. That's right.
From this, can I ask? Okay, sorry. So there will be only one standard deviation for a graph, or can I plot the line that you drew now, like 4 or 7? Can't I draw it lower where it's much more flat, more curvier?
No. No, no. How exactly it is calculated is, it has to cover. So when you are drawing this line, right? I have this end and this end. I did draw these particular lines. These lines are drawn in such a way that in middle, between these two lines, you are covering 68% of the population. 68% of the population, if you see here, the 68% of the population are in between these two lines. That's how you need to draw those particular lines. You can't draw these particular lines anywhere.
So 68 is fixed, is it? For whatever the data fixed.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes. Got it. So if you have more flatter curve, you are actually drawing it wider because you need to cover those 68% people, right? So that is where the distance really, increases. So, and one more point to note, right? I mean, typically in case of normal distribution, how you see is this is left side of the population and this is right side of the population. What you are saying is you take this middle value as a zero. That's where you are actually, started studying this particular entire data. You are fixing that as the point of reference rather. And then you are saying that these many people are less and these many people are more than this, right? So you can actually take this as the middle and the graph goes equally on this side and this side. So that is the typical normal distribution. So here as well, when you take 68% of the population and drawing this particular thing, this covers two standard deviations. So basically M minus one standard deviation, M plus one standard deviation. Okay. So effectively this is covering two standard deviations.
I'm sorry, I didn't get that, Praveen. I thought the standard deviation would be the entire curve. Like you've drawn a line there to show four,
no,
right?
No. Yeah. So basically take this as the middle, right? I mean, this is four. So if you take this middle, so two is this side and two is this side, right? Because four is divided into two parts here. One is the left side two, one is the right side two.
The standard deviation is not four. Okay. It's actually
two. Standard deviation is not four. Standard deviation is two. This is M minus one standard deviation. This side is M plus one standard deviation.
Can I ask one more?
The total distance would be two standard deviations. Yeah.
Can I ask one more question? This, the bell curve on the right side, the 50 is the median or the mean? Or is it the same? Median and mean are different. Now, so is it the same in this case?
It's mean, not median.
The mean.
Yeah, that's average. Right. Yeah.
How do you show? Do you have to show the median also on this graph?
No, distribution is actually based on the mean, not the median.
Okay, all right.
If you are putting a frequency distribution, then it could be median way, but it is mean. So it is all the right. Average height.
All right, okay.
Okay, Praveen, can I pitch in with an example? Might help if I go wrong.
Definitely, why not?
Okay.
Definitely.
Yeah, this guy, the color is the picture, right? This is also called a bell curve, if you heard about it. And we in software industry, we fight with this every year when we restructure the salaries of engineers. Okay. So this is a fun thing to fight with. I'll tell you an example in the right side. Oh, whichever. So let's say the x-axis, the 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, that is less than number of people getting a specific salary. Okay, in the same band, so senior software engineer, 20 of them gets a specific salary. That salary is plotted in the y-axis on the top. Now 30 people gets another salary, 40 of them gets another salary, 50 of them, most of them gets the average salary. This is the important point we seniors focus on. Most of the people should be getting an average salary so that minimum people are worried about it. Some people will be getting lower salary. Some people will be getting upper, higher end salary. So same software engineers, some of them will be getting, let's say 4 lakhs. Some of them will be getting on the other extreme, 6 lakhs. The middle people, average people will be always getting 5 lakhs. So the mean is, let's say 5 lakhs. The lower end will be 4 lakhs, upper end will be 6 lakhs. Now, the concept of standard deviation comes in play with something called variance. So we, now this much is hopefully clear. The 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, those are the number of, those are the, let's say, salaries of people. And upper, the y-axis is the number of people getting the salary. So most of people are getting 50, I cannot say 50 lakhs, but let's say 50,000 per month. Median is 50,000 per month. Most of the people are getting 50,000 per month. I might have mixed up the X and Y axis, but I think it's clear. Most of the people, have, on an average, people are getting 50,000 per month. Some people, less than number, gets less salary, 40,000. Similarly, some people gets little more salary, 60,000. But those numbers are little less than the average number. So far clear? So the mean is what the most of the people will be getting. Little more people will be getting little lower, 40. Some even further lower, 30. Some even further lower, 20. Some little more than the average, they are extra performing people. Some even better than that, 70. Some extremely good people, they are getting the best salary, that is 80,000 per month. This is the distribution now. Now each of these, they are how much apart they are from the center, from the mean. That is a variance. Actually, the square of that is a variance. So if you take 40, for example, 40 is deviation is like, let's say 50. So 50, that's a 10, like 50 minus 10, that is the variance. So X minus mu that you see down in the equation is the variance. X is the mean, that is 50. Mu is the difference, that so 40. So for 40 and 60, it's going to be 10. X minus mu is going to be 10, and you have to square it. When you're squaring, minus and positive becomes same, so it becomes 100. Both, when you square it, it becomes 100 by n. N is the number of counts. So basically, deviation practically is how apart from mean, how distant from mean are in general the population. So when you say in some companies, most of the people are getting same salary. So if you are high performing and low performing and all, you always get somewhat same salary. That means all the people are getting 50,000. The worst performing guy will be getting 45,000. The best performing guy will be getting 55,000. So cloud will be, you know, the bell will be very, very minuscule. So you can very easily predict that your standard deviation is very less. What was the technical word for it? In some other ones, it will be very flat. Means what? Some worst kind of guys are getting very low salary. Best guys will be getting very high salary. So it will be more flat kind of a bell. So far, I made any sense, Praveen?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Can one of you just tell what those symbols, how to read those symbols, what, like mu, is that okay. Can you?
Okay. So my advice there is probably don't get into those particular symbols to start with. Okay. Right. So we'll come to those particular symbols. So those particular formulas, probably just keep it aside, because I think that is going to confuse you more. Because I think formulas are something that anyway, you know, that can be, you know, referred or get used very easily. So don't worry about it.
Okay. It
was a really good example, I think. I think it kind of really clarified it. I think between the two of you, I'm feeling more confident now.
Thank you. So anyway, going further, right? I mean, so whatever the concepts that we have planned, and using that, I'll very simplistically tell what exactly this chapter is all about. So the first chapter is talking about parametric statistics and non-parametric statistics. So we talked about population, we talked about sample, we talked about certain ways of analyzing the data with mean, median, mode, standard deviation, and all these things, right? So by now, I think everybody would have got a grasp in terms of how exactly data would be studied. So let's say you have a very large sample of data, and you are very confident that I can really, you know, plot that data, whatever that we have, and put a curve like this, or a normal deviation, like a normal distribution. And then I can study the data. I'm pretty confident that my data sample is of a huge size. And I can really, you know, study the entire data using all these parameters like standard deviation or whatever the, you know, deductions that I can make using this particular graphs. So if studying based on these parameters are possible, that typical way of studying is called as parametric statistics. So you have parameters and you are actually able to deduce those particular things from, you know, by plotting these graphs and then telling that this is where the median is, this is where the mean is, this is the standard deviation, this is the variance. All these things are really, you know, deduced by these distributions. But in certain cases, it might not be possible, or you are not really, you know, confident to put this particular graphs. You have only 10 values, let's say. 10 samples, and you have to deduce something out of those particular 10 samples. The sample size is very less. So if you plot those 10 samples, you might not really get a bell curve. You might get some other curves, some 10 dots here and there, right? So you are not really sure what kind of data is this. You have only 10. So you can't really use the same techniques to study that particular data. So there are different types of techniques to study that kind of a data. That is exactly is a non-parametric statistics. So is that clear? So the entire chapter is talking about that studies, what exactly is a parametric statistics, how to study a parametric data. So it doesn't really go into the details of each and every methodology to an extent. It is only talking about at a high level that, okay, yes, in case of parametric statistics, in these particular conditions, you are going to use parametric statistics. In these particular conditions, you are going to use non-parametric statistics. And some of the examples in terms of for non-parametric statistics, these are the typical, you know, methods. So it doesn't really go into those particular methods in detail, but a sample names for us to refer further. Right? So it talks about advantages. If there are, you know, advantages of non-parametric statistics, what are they? What are the disadvantages of non-parametric statistics? How exactly, you know, the both parametric and statistics and non-parametric statistics really, you know, vary. So this is all about. So that is where we started with population sample and briefly explained these particular concepts so that you can really make sense what these particular statistics are, parametric or non-parametric are. And so now what I'll do, I'll go through one of these, I mean, these particular chapters. So still there are a lot of basics that really require to be understood, but as and when we get along those particular terms, then we can go to the basics of them and then study, I mean, try to understand what those are, and then come back again to the syllabus or whatever that is there in this particular chapter. So that's the plan. I hope that is fine with everybody, right? So
yeah, that's a good plan, Praveen, because statistics, the main thing is the basics. I'm so glad you started from data and, you know, you went with all these mean, median, mode and all that. Because parameters and all, from this only we'll be able to understand what parameters is and then carry on to actually, you know, do the statistics part of it. So glad. And please take as many classes as you think is necessary to cover the basics.
I agree.
Praveen.
When the basics is
just
done.
A second. Yeah. Ritika, Praveen, you want to stop the recording? Ritika, you want to stop the recording now?
Yeah.
Praveen, I'll halt you for 5 minutes here. I want to pitch in for, say, 5-10 minutes about something.